So now we are going to look at what happens with aerobic respiration in our seventh lab of respiration. So this lab, we are going to look at the fermentation tubes for anaerobic respiration and here aerobic respiration, which means we're going to be using oxygen, right? Oxygen, aerobic respiration. So this, we are going to be using a very nice organism called the pea.
Garden peas.
That's okay. A lot of people don't like peas.
It's okay.
They're kind of gross when they're mushy. Anyway,
like
so
peas.
The peas are going to kind of still be alive. They're going to be rooting and kind of growing, hopefully. Hopefully not rotting. And then they are going to be using oxygen, and we're going to kind of measure how much the oxygen they use. So we're going to use this beautiful fermentation chamber, aka big jar. And inside of it, there are three tubes. Okay, so these three tubes, Liz is going to try to carefully pull out. Please be careful when you do this. They're really big and huge. Okay, so these are large test tubes that are going to be holding on to peas and beads. So two of them are gonna have peas in it. Those peas should be, you should have about 30 peas in each of the two test tubes. And then the other one is gonna be our control. That's the one we're gonna put beads in, and we're gonna use that one in our demo today. So you're gonna put in the 30 peas. They should weigh about the same, approximately. And then the third one is going to be filled with beads that should also weigh about the same as the peas. So if you have 30 peas that are weighing about 50 grams, you should weigh out the beads to be about 50 grams. Okay, and when you put them in, are you putting in more?
I'm going to put a few more.
All right, a few more.
It'll make me putting cotton in a little easier.
So this is going to be our control, technically our negative control, because it shouldn't do anything, because beads are dead or never alive, I suppose. They aren't even dead. They were never alive. They do not go through aerobic respiration, therefore they shouldn't use any oxygen.
They don't do any of those seven things. They're not reproducing.
They just are, beads. They're fun to play with. So when you make these tubes for the peas and the beads, you're going to put in a huge chunk of cotton. Okay, not too huge. That's big enough. Make sure that your cotton is about the same size in all three of your tubes as well. Got it? And then on top of the cotton, so make sure the cotton is going to be kind of sealing, because it's going to protect the beads and the peas from our friend the soda lime. Now, soda lime is a drying agent. It will dry out your hands a lot. Here, let me see. Like major production value. There it is. And these soda lime is going to go on top of the cotton, which we forgot a little scooper thing, and no one should have to pick that up. Are you going to scoop it in?
I'm just going to scoop
some. There you go. We're going to watch her scoop some in. So you'll have a little spatula to help you do this in lab. Now, this soda lime is going to sit on top of the cotton, so the soda lime shouldn't touch the peas or the beads, because this is, again, a drying agent. It's going to help to catch a lot of the carbon dioxide. So remember, these are going to be going through aerobic respiration, which means they're using oxygen, and they're going to be releasing carbon dioxide as a waste product. Now, in our closed system, we're going to show you in a second, if the carbon dioxide is leaving as oxygen is coming in, that's going to throw off all of our numbers. And since this lab is going to be a complete quantitative lab, we need our numbers to be good. So the soda lime will help suck up the carbon dioxide and not screw with our numbers, I hope. All right.
Fingers crossed.
Yes. So then you're going to take the tube, put it back into our fermentation chamber, and we have these fancy tube things that are going to go on top of them.
Water.
Oh, yeah. Inside this. All right. So you guys have the test tube full of peas and beads. Inside the jar, you're going to have water. You're going to, depending on which group you're in, you're either going to have cold water, which will be ice water at about 0 degrees, or you are going to have warm-ish water at about 20 degrees. And make sure you do test your temperature, because if you use hot water out of the tap, it will probably kill your beads. Water coming out of the tap can be over 45, 50 degrees Celsius, so that will definitely cause a problem with our experiment. 20 degrees. Use the thermometer. So then on top of each one of these tubes, we're going to shove a stopper with a tube attached to it, technically two tubes. So the stopper will go in, and right now, I'm going to turn it like this so we can kind of see it. There are two little capillary tubes, larger than capillary tubes, but they're tubes. Nice. And they're attached to two hoses. Okay, so, and we're going to go big production value here. All right, you guys are paying for the best. So at the top, one side is going to have a clamp on it. Now, when
you start,
this clamp should be open. Okay, that's going to give us a nice environment for our peas and beets to equalize. And then the other side, this longer tube, I'm back zooming out. I need one of those cool cars that they have that you watch them do behind the scenes on the really cool videos.
Like I said, Universal has nothing.
Yeah, right. So at the end of this longer tube, you're going to shove in the metal glass tube.
Maybe.
So be careful when you do this. These can be a little bit fragile, so don't break it. It would not be cool. Then you get your capillary tube, and you're going to lay it on top of a whiteboard. Now, this whiteboard should be clean. Ours totally isn't, which is probably really what you'll walk into a lab. There'll be little marks all over it. Hey, and then this is going to get taped down onto the board with some very high-tech masking tape. So you're going to tape it down so that it will stay steady on this, and you'll have all three of them taped here. But also notice that at the end, you're going to have a little bit of the glass hanging off there. This is where you're going to insert the dye.
I'm just shifting it a little so they can mark their dye.
Who needs production value?
Yes.
Liz changes everything
I'm
on you.
I'm so sorry.
It's all right. You are going to add in just a little bit of dye.
So the green dye makes
the green dye appears again. This is actually what you're really going to use the green dye for. It's not your yeast. Remember that. Yeah. So you're going to take a syringe.
Okay. Not 1 milliliter.
You're going to add in,
this all in
a little bit, which ends up being, what is it, a millimeter?
I think it's a...
1 to 1.5 centimeters. So you can use the ruler that we have in the back of the lab to put in a and you notice this is a little bit messy as she keeps trying to do this.
Sorry.
Make sure that your lab books are nowhere near here because you'll have green all over them. And use a nice paper towel to clean up the green. Hey, and you're going to put in a little tiny bit. Are you going to get a little more in there?
I got to close that because it's pushing out.
There you go. It's still pushing out a little bit.
Gonna push out just a tiny bit because we don't actually have.
So these are also gonna have to equalize for a little bit as you go through the lab. You'll have to equalize for 5 minutes or so. Oh, look what I did.
That was
all my fault. So the green dye you can kind of see sitting here on the end. That green dye is gonna move throughout the experiment as the peas are going to be using oxygen. So now that we have a closed chamber, so up here at the top. We're going to close this off using the clamp so it gets closed, which means these peas and beads down here are only going to be able to get oxygen through this metal rubber, this metal. The rubber tube connected to the glass tube down here. So if oxygen can only come from here, as the peas use oxygen, the green dye is going to move if the peas are using oxygen. So remember, as they're going through aerobic respiration, they still are going to be using oxygen, releasing carbon dioxide. Even though they're plants, they still are going to use oxygen and release carbon dioxide. Please, plants always use. I'm going to get mad and stomp my fist.
I'm with you.
So the oxygen will get pulled in. The carbon dioxide, remember, is going to get sucked up by the soda lime that is sitting on top of the cotton. I should stop recording videos now so that we don't have any interference, right? So the soda lime sucks up the carbon dioxide sitting on top of the cotton. The oxygen will move the dye. As the dye moves, we will then measure it. And we have a conversion in our book we'll talk about a little bit later of how many centimeters per milliliter of oxygen is going to be used. We good?
We're good.
Did I stumble enough?
No, I thought it was fabulous. Right, you're fantastic.